Hi, it's Carly McAvoy. I wanted to show you an example where you're given a range of values and asked to find the mean of the data set. When you're given a range like 40 to 42, then at the frequency of 3, what you have to do is use the midpoints. Now, the midpoints are the average between 40 and 44, so that'd be 42. And then 45 and 49, the average would be 47, 52, 57, 62. So the midpoints are here. And plus you need to know the total frequency, which is just the sum of all the frequencies that are given. And so what that would look like if you were doing that on your calculator or something would be 42 times 3, because there's a frequency of 3 for that particular data class, and then 47 times 4, 52 times 10, 57 times 6, 62 times 2, and then you would add all that together and then divide by the total frequency, which is 25, and that would give you the answer for the average. And then you have to read the directions in blue of how they're asked to enter that, how you're asked to enter that. If they ask you to go to the tenths, then we want to write 52.0. And then the last thing about this is they say, which of the following best describes the relationship between the computed mean and the actual mean? And it's a little deceptive, I think, the way this is stated. It says the computed mean is not close to the actual mean, because the difference between the means is more than 5%. Now you can see up here they say the mean is 56.2, and our computed one was 52. And so at first glance people think that doesn't look like it's 5, but that's not percent. So what you have to do to figure that part out is take the actual and subtract the computed one, and then divide by the actual, and that's going to give you the percent difference. And if you move that over two places, you could see that would be 7.47%. And so we can see that it's more than 5% when we do it that way, right? When we actually look at the percentage. I wanted to show you how you could do this in StatCrunch as well. So let's see if I can bring that up without too much trouble. So here it is, the same kind of thing. Yeah, same question. It might be the frequencies are a little different because they're different every time. But what I can do is go right into StatCrunch, click on that, drop down to open in StatCrunch. Remember, I've already done a video on how to use StatCrunch, and also you can go onto YouTube and find videos and to learn more about StatCrunch. I would not consider myself an expert in that. But anyways, what I'm going to do now is I don't want to use 40 or 45. I want to use the number in the middle or the midpoint of that. So I'm going to go to Stat in Summary Stats, and then I'm going to drop down to Grouped or Bin Data. Now I'm going to select the variable that I'm interested in. I want to use that low temperature column, and I want to use the frequencies where they are. And then notice here it says the midpoints are defined by the average of the limits, and the limit between 40 and 44, for instance, those are the class limits. So that's my midpoint. And then I can click on Compute. Remember, Compute is just down at the bottom here. So I can click on Compute, and it's going to show me that there was an N of 25. That's the frequency which we saw before in the other one. This particular set was a little different, so the mean is 50.6. But that is calculated on the midpoint by going to that specific bin data choice in there. So you can do that on StatCrunch. You can also calculate the midpoints on your own and put them into your calculator. That's up to you. I just want to show you two different ways to complete that problem. And the other piece of that problem that I think is probably most important is this idea of the difference. People miss that a lot, so I want to make sure and go over that. Okay, have a fantastic day, and we'll see you next time.